Are we rolling already?
Sorry. Hi, welcome to Talking Tech. I'm your host, Alejandro Hoyos. And as you can see, I was having a great time with this new handheld from MSI. And to tell us a bit more, hey man, how's it going today?
Pretty good, how are you?
Doing good, good. Yes, so this has been very, very excited and very dear to my heart, especially because I've been looking for like a handheld. And now we have Intel's in the handheld market, which this is awesome. I was playing Assassin's Creed Mirage and it looks great.
Yeah.
So why don't you tell us a little bit more about this great product?
Yeah, so this is our first handheld gaming device, and this is the Claw. We want to first talk about the processor. So inside, we have the Intel Core Ultra 7 processor, and we will also have the Intel Core Ultra 5 processor in there as another option as well. In terms of spec sheet, you could go up to 32 gigs of RAM. You have a 1 terabyte storage as well. And I think one of the best features for Intel Core Ultra is that you also get a Thunderbolt 4.
Thunderbolt 4.
Okay, yeah, that's Thunderbolt pretty 4, neat. Yeah.
And you also, so it's, this is Intel Core Ultra, you also have the built-in ARC graphics with it that comes with that,
with the XeSS. Yeah. So everything comes in a full package, and having this kind of performance, with the Intel Core Ultra processor, it's a lot more efficient and it's also battery life saving too.
That's awesome. So one thing that let me grab this one for a second. The one thing that I was actually, we were talking before we started shooting, what I really like is this one is really like the ergonomics of this compared to some of the other ones that I've played with or been able to see. I really like it because I can really like have a good grasp of the whole device. I really like it. It's pretty close, and you guys done a great thing about it. And also, I see a lot of vents. So why don't you tell us a little bit more about that?
Yeah, so one of the things that you want a handheld device is that you want the ergonomic designs, right? You're playing this for like, 2-3 hours at a time, and you want to make sure that you can feel comfortably, typing it, getting all the buttons correctly, and everything is just right at the place. The other thing, like you mentioned about, a lot of people mention, these things kind of get hot. So for this, we really wanted to make sure that our first device, that we wanted to make sure that we have 2 fans and 2 heat pipes inside and a full ventilation on the back, as you can see. And that way you can exhaust all the hot air out so that when you're playing through those long durations, you don't feel like it's warming up at all.
Nice. I like it. Also, I was looking here at the top and you guys here have the Thunderbolt port entry. Yeah. You have a micro SD card for memory expansion.
And an audio jack.
I know. It's funny because these are some, nowadays, kind of hard to find.
It's kind of hard, yeah.
Yeah, but I really like it. This is a great product, man. Yeah. And also, the other thing that we were talking about earlier.
Yes, we were also talking about these 2 macro keys that's on your on these 2 sides, right on the side. So these 2 are actually macroable keys that you could put in. So people, like, let's say they're playing fighting games for sure, right?
Right.
So they could actually use those buttons and they could toggle like a slight left or a slight right, and then use those as one of those their buttons to play. Yeah.
So another thing that we also keep in mind, especially when you're gaming, especially since we're traveling a lot with all the events and everything, it's the battery life. What can you tell us about the battery life?
Yeah, so this actually houses one of the biggest batteries right now, which is a 53-watt-hour battery. And I've been playing it for a while, and I got down maybe playing Forza for like 2 hours or so, and it's still running pretty smoothly. And it also, the battery life is still pretty fair. So I would say you could probably get up to 2 to 3 hours just by playing it like full long time. Oh, and also we have our...
I'm gonna get that eventually.
Yeah, and then we also have our Titan 18HX.
Wow, this is amazing. This is beautiful. So tell me about this. What do you have in here?
Yeah, so it houses the Intel Core i9 processor, the 14900HX inside. And it also has a RTX 4090 as well. And I think 2 of the biggest features that we really love to talk about is that we have an 18-inch mini LED 120 hertz screen display. And as you can see, this really flashy thing, this is actually a seamless haptic touchpad, RGB as well.
Wow. So what you have here is the 14900HX in here, and also you have a GTX 4090 in it. So pretty much everything that's top of the line is amazing. And also, so you have a SteelSeries keyboard, which for those of us who love the keyboards.
Oh yeah, so this is actually a mechanical keyboard too. So this is a Cherry Red MX keyboard. And so when you're typing it, it could actually feel more like an actual keyboard that you would have on a separate device, but now all in one single package.
I really like the feel and touch. This is pretty great. All right, so what else do we have here on the when it comes to the I/O?
Yeah, so right now we have 3-sided I/O ports. So you have your 2 USBs and you have your SD. Oh. And if you flip
again.
And then this is all your display, right? So your charger, your HDMI, and your Ethernet. And then if you flip.
Hold on. Look, it's another sign-in of an RJ45 that you didn't see that often.
Yeah.
It's beautiful. Also known as Ethernet. Anyway, sorry. Switch it.
Yes, and then you know we also have another USB and two Type-Cs.
Oh, nice.
And an audio jack.
Audio jack.
This is a Type-C Thunderbolt 4.
Awesome, those are awesome. Yes, I love it. This is great, man. And battery life?
We have a 99.9 watt hour battery. So it's one of the largest battery that you can put up, go into the airplane with. And so we try to keep it that way. And also, like you mentioned about the internal components, this actually houses one of the biggest vapor chamber cooling systems inside too.
Oh, pretty cool. So that's what kind of what we're seeing, I guess. Yeah. We'll show it a little bit later in a close up, but like back here, right? Like
yeah, all the. So the vapor chamber, if we like lift it over here, it's basically this whole piece. And then the two fans sits here. And we also have these new cool 3D cooling stands so that ventilation can actually go into the stand itself and burst hot air outside.
Nice, yeah. So you can see like the cuts out here for the innovation.
Yeah, so yeah, definitely.
That's awesome. So what about the configuration, memory, storage, and the other stuff in
there? So memory wise, so we have four slots. And in theory, if we have a 48 gigs of RAM now, it could go up to 192 gigs of RAM. And for the hard drive wise, we have three SSD slots, and one of them is a PCIe Gen 5. And so that way, you can have a lot of storage inside, and you know the capacity for upgradability is all there.
Yeah, it's amazing because you said like you have all those empty slots for memory and also for your drive, and yeah, so like for the DIY, it's a great buy. This is awesome, man. Appreciate it. This is a great product.
It is. It definitely is.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Yeah, no problem.
Hi, Anne. How's it going?
Good. So I'm Anne. I'm a laptop marketing manager. So today we are bringing three different types of the Pristine system. So the Pristine system is featured with Intel Core Ultra 9. Yes. And also you can see there are two Thunderbolts on the back. So you can make the make the table quite like clean and tidy.
Yeah, it's a cleaner when you're trying to connect, when you're working in a desk. And also you have your USB, your HDMI output there. Here you have, actually, this is pretty useful, especially in events.
Yes, the Kennington lock, right?
Yeah, the lock so you can lock your laptop so it doesn't grow legs and walk away.
So it actually also had a full-size SD card over there. So for content creators, it's actually very useful too.
Yeah, so full SD and another sighting of an audio jack.
Yeah, and also there's an Ethernet port, no more dongle for traveling, right?
I love it. Look, it's another RJ45, yay! Yeah. So this is awesome, all right. Yeah. So I can see, so this guy is with the Intel Core Ultra 9, so which has Intel's latest Meteor Lake architecture in it.
Yes.
So that means it's disaggregated and it's specifically designed for power savings. So the power savings on this must be really great. So can you tell us a little bit more about battery lifetime?
Yeah, so actually shopping with a 99.9 and thanks to Intel Meteor Lake, so the battery can go more than 16 hours.
Oh, wow.
So yeah, all day productivity. Yes, and also you can see the panels, it go with OLED panel.
Oh, nice, so this is an OLED panel, and also you have your camera.
Camera shutters on the top.
And camera shutter, I think you also have like a security device that you can actually turn it on and off, right?
Yes, we do. We have a software and also the hardware, like a shutter, so make sure your security got covered.
Right, and also that OLED pan with the Intel built-in ARC graphics that are inside the processor, it's a great combination for it.
Yes. So I think it's really great for like productivity and also graders. You can have a using for everyday usage too.
And also you have different sizes, right? Different sizes with different configurations?
For sure. Yeah, we have 13 inch with the Prestige 13 Evo AI and also the 14 inch one. So Prestige 14 Evo AI too.
Nice.
And both of them have a studio version if you want to use the discrete graphics.
Right. Yes. And also, like you said, it's AI, so it has all of the different features and capabilities that will take advantage of the processor's NPU. So the neural processing unit that helps with all the AI applications that you guys have.
Yes, for sure.
And now, Anne, thank you very much. Appreciate
it. Thank you, Alex.
Have a great day.
How's Good to see you again, Alex.
Good to see you, man. It's been a while.
Yeah, we had last talk when the 14th generation desktop processors launched. I would like to show you guys and everyone our new motherboards called Project Zero. So we have two of them here. They're compatible with Intel.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, what first look, is there anything you noticed different, Alex?
Yeah, it's a little bit different. So I know that this is a Z790, right?
This one's a Z790.
And then you have here a B760, right?
Correct. That's also B760.
All right. So let me take a quick look at it. I mean, they look beautiful. They're very beautiful aesthetic. These are, I mean, you can tell that they're hefty, but I'm trying to see, like, there's some connectors seem to be missing. So I don't know, you can tell us a little bit more about it.
Great. So let's blow everyone's mind. Alex, turn it around.
Wow.
Yeah. So what's special about our Project Zero is we got back connects. Everything like the power, the fan headers, RGB headers, you know, stuff that you would traditionally find on the front of motherboard or on the side of motherboard has everything moved to the back. Leaving just the processor socket, the PCI slots, and the memory DIMMs on the front.
And the idea behind it is to have, like, you know, a cleaner build, right? Less cables, less clutter in the front, have it up with something better to show.
Of course. So we do have some demonstration builds. We're going to roll by the audience to take a look at that. Look at those. So when it's fully built out, it becomes a lot more obvious that, you know, some of the cables, when you take them out, it really shows how clean your build will look. With the motherboard, those back connects, really cleaning up that front of the case in that build goes a long way. Even when building in that cable management, you're just doing it from one side. You don't have to route it through the case, through the front, and have to go back and forth, trying to plan out those lines for cable management. You can all do it from just one side of the case, and that's behind the motherboard tray.
Do the motherboards have to have like a specific case in order for it to fit, or they're designed with that in mind to be able to fit in all the other cases
yes.
out there?
Yes. So what I'm showing here are our cutouts in the on the motherboard tray that shows how, you know, how perfect we got these back connections to line up with the cutouts, so that when people mount the motherboard, you know, there's no fitment issues, nothing's bumping against each other. They can just go ahead, see those connections, and plug it right in.
Oh, this is beautiful. I really like what you guys done, you know, all the innovation coming through, and I know, trying to get to that next step of the next build, especially for DIY community. I think this is awesome. Definitely great to see you guys taking to the next step.
Of course, it's been a pleasure.
Thank you, Dave, appreciate it.
Thank you, Alex.
All right, so right now we're here with Jorge, and we're gonna be talking about desktops, specifically this new desktop from MSI. Hi, Jorge, how's it going?
It's going great, how are you?
Good, man. So tell me a little bit more about this beautiful piece of art.
Sure, so here at CES, we're showcasing our huge lineup of pre-built desktops. And right here, we have our cream of the crop. So this is one of our Assembled in America desktops, our Vision RS, which is featuring our Maestro case. And this Maestro case, what's unique about it, and you can tell, is that it has a single tempered glass panel that just wraps around the entire thing. So it's a unibody with the glass and also with the metal chassis. What's great about this chassis is also compatible with our new Intel Project Zero motherboards. So it has a lot of customizability, and you know, it's packing the top of the line components, you know, up to the Intel Core i9 14th gen processor and, you know, the latest graphics cards as well. Besides that, you have tons of cooling options. It's really easy to get into. All you do is remove two screws and you kind of just bring out the glass panel and you're good to go ahead and access. So it's great for enthusiasts that love to, you know, tinker with their systems, and it uses nothing but non-proprietary parts. So everything's off the shelf, and that gives you, you know, the option to upgrade down the line, as opposed to other pre-builds you might see that, you know, it's hard to get into there.
That's awesome. So you can go to the MSI website, do the configuration or whatever you like, or, you know, you give different options, I guess. Or...
Right. So on our website, we showcase a few different configurations for that. I will say, though, this one will probably not be available until around March.
Okay.
And around that time, you should be able to see all the possible configurations for our Vision series.
Awesome. Thank you. And this is only available, going to be only available in Canada and the US.
That's correct. Yeah, this is for the North American market.
Okay. Jorge, thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Of course. Thanks for your time.